An excerpt from Organization Day, 1944 booklet, AAA 117th Battalion. The 117th AAA Battalion was formed in March 1943. They were organized similarly to other artillery battalions, described above. They may have been located in this desolate swampland, but the GIs didn't lack for entertainment by such people as Paramount's singing star Dick Powell, and later by Joe Louis, the world-famous boxing champion, who went a few rounds with GIs for fun. The 18 weeks of training started with the basics of M1 rifle instruction and target practice, and all the other basic training for survival skills. The fifth week of training took the whole battalion on its first bivouac at Topsail Inlet. It was the first taste of overnight camping for many of the men, but they went at it with determination. It was a good experience for these guys and made them feel like real veterans. The ninth week saw the battalion move out to Topsail for their initial practice firing the 90mm guns. The men were very effective for the first time out, and all were enthusiastic over the results. The second practice firing was held at Topsail during the 11th week of training. 18 hits were scored out of about 400 rounds, which was proclaimed a very successful shoot. The 14th week of training saw the machine gunners get their second chance at firing. The first practice, plus the additional work by all the gunners, resulted in a tremendous improvement, and many hits were made upon the sleeve target during the firing. As they approached the end of the 18 weeks training, most were looking forward to being shipped overseas to the war. But they were also offered the possibility of staying at Camp Davis as trainers for AA. Some saw this as a lucky break and took advantage of it. About this time, the battalion had its first opportunity to hold a dance, and a very successful one was held at the service club. Music was provided by the Air Corps Band, but during the intermission, the 117th's own boys furnished the sweet and hot musical numbers. Their performance promised a lot for the future. Officers and enlisted attended the dance, and the wives of both who lived in the vicinity were there. Additional girls from Wilmington, and many girls employed by the camp as well as the WACS, stationed at Camp Davis, had a good time. During the summer, weekend convoys to the beaches and to Sears Landing and Topsail Inlet proved very popular, and practically the entire battalion took advantage of the opportunity for the pleasant relief from its school duties. In October 1943, Batteries B and C gave a demonstration firing for the benefit of news reporters and photographers. The demonstration proved to be very effective. Two targets were shot down, one with 9 rounds. The battalion received a commendation from Major General J.A. Green, who observed training at the AAA school with his staff officers in November. He reported, "The 90mm night firing by the school troops of the 117th Battalion was superior. The accuracy of this fire is convincing proof of their capabilities." In November, the outfit moved to Farmingdale, Long Island, to set up their artillery to protect the U.S. coast. Justin Raphael, Officer Candidate School, OCS. Camp Davis had, as part of its training program, an Officer Candidate School. These programs were a vital piece of military life, as the growing number of recruits needed strong, capable officers to provide instruction and leadership. Justin Raphael was one of those trained at Camp Davis, and his story typifies what these soldiers experienced. Raphael was born in April 1923 and grew up in New York City. In January 1943, he was inducted into the Army at Fort Dix, New Jersey, and then shipped to Fort Eustis, Virginia, for basic training. After 8 weeks of training that included setting up and tearing down 90mm AA gun emplacements, he was chosen to enter an OCS prep school in a tent camp on the outskirts of Fort Eustis. Having passed the course, he was made a corporal and transferred to Camp Davis, North Carolina, to attend the Officer Candidate School, OCS, in May of 1943. OCS at Camp Davis was a difficult and stressful testing and training period that was meant to make certain that officers who were graduated were qualified to lead. Many candidates were young and naive. They were mostly in their early 20s. Justin was 20 when he was graduated as a second lieutenant on November 11, 1943. About 50% of the OCS candidates washed out. Justin recalls, The last week of OCS was spent at Sears Landing for live firing of a 40mm AA gun at the drones. Only the candidates who would be graduated at the end of the week went to Topsail for the firing. Down the beach, the 90mm guns were firing. Suddenly, we saw a plane enter their field of fire. We were horrified when it was hit. We felt terrible that the pilot and the crew had to be dead. We were naive kids. The plane was a pilotless drone. After graduation, Justin was chosen to stay in Camp Davis and joined the 576th AA Self-Propelled Battalion in Swamp Hollow, which was being organized to train as a unit. The barracks were tar paper and wood on concrete foundations. Due to its growing mastery of the air, the United States no longer needed so many AAA officers. So in January 1944, Raphael was transferred to the infantry at Fort Benning, Georgia, for special officers' infantry training and further assignment. In 1950, Justin married a local girl, Shirley Berger, and settled in Wilmington, not far from Camp Davis. He remains involved in veterans' activities and the American Legion, and in the United States Volunteers, in which he participates in honor guard and veteran funerals.